Like signed, sealed, and delivered.
Aww.
Dead letter offices in Groton.
We find
right by the side of the ocean.
Every single owner of every single letter. If we can't, we return it to the sender.
Even if it's for Santa Claus?
Oh, we actually...
It's sent to Santa Claus.
No, we actually make sure Santa Claus gets those letters. Yeah. And those kids get written back too.
Good job.
Yep.
I wouldn't send it to Santa Claus. That's his own mail. You don't take Santa's
We're pretty
mail.
Good.
All right, is everyone ready?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And we're recording?
Yes,
Mark.
Sir.
Mark, you got
yes,
that?
Yes, I said three times.
Huh? Let's make a chair. All right, so you guys are at the cave. You guys rested. You cut up and...
ate some Yeti.
Ate some Yetis.
Yeti spaghetti.
Jack's jerky.
Guide, would you like to guide them the last day's
deficit's
journey?
Deficit's going to jump to 900 million.
Please.
Give us a survival roll.
Why are you... What are you giving us the news during D&D? What are you, the reporter?
Just popped up on my phone.
All right, that day... You guys got the wrong path.
What?
You didn't make it by the end of the day.
It's $100.
Give us another roll.
Bill.
This is not the path we were looking for.
16.
All right.
We found the path.
Mm. Heavy snows
so
that day.
So now you're down to 5 rations a piece. And you find where you knew where this is, because you'd known your people had moved back in here when the witches returned. Before you left. This is what they call the Tomb of Damas.
Oh, not the Tomb of Damas.
It stands before you,
Dumas.
Appearing to be carved from the ivory bones of some dread serpent, with a tight skin of ice pulled over them. Bitter cold, howling wind issues from the mouth of this creature, as if to greet you to its depths, while whispering can be heard deep within it, calling you to enter.
It definitely is it. Like Dumas.
Is the call? What's it saying?
Come to me.
Do you like what's that?
Can we roll for traps? I just want to inspect the area, make sure there's no traps. I mean, you are the resident rogue here.
I can.
That'd be nice, if possible.
Do we see any like guards posted? No, no, no guards. Just noise.
Ooh, that's funny.
You do not find any guards. However, in your search, you do get the impression you are being watched.
Uh-oh.
I always feel like somebody's
watching
me.
Who's playing tricks on me? Ooh-hoo. Name a singer, anyone?
Yeah,
Michael
I know.
Jackson.
Nope.
No, but...
Freddie Mercury?
No.
Nope.
No. We're... I know who it is. Just give me a second. Well, I guess we should plainly enter. I don't mind if maybe someone hangs out as we enter to see if we're being followed.
Are you saying this as a polar bear?
No, I'm
okay. That would be awesome. Wait, are you one of these
it's been
like everyone's like,
no.
Have a Snickers. You kind of sound like a polar bear when you're hungry.
And then you turn into like
can you?
All right, so I was Steve paid Buscemi. To take you.
What?
There, not here.
That's it?
You're on your own if you want to go in.
Ooh, wow.
As a guide, there is the payment for the return.
That means you have to come
I didn't
out
say
of
I'm leaving, I'm saying I'm standing right here.
He's not moving inside, he's saying.
He was never paid to have us returned just to get there.
What? Do you mind, in all good faith, making sure that no one enters into these caves?
It'll cost you.
I'm not a wealthy man.
But this guy is.
How much?
Mark!
What are we talking here?
You're not the fighter of this game, you're just the spender.
Lord Moneybags.
Like Donald Trump.
I got 700. Unlimited amounts of money.
You'd get some Yeti out of the deal.
That's nothing. So, that means nothing.
I did that myself.
About 500.
How about 575?
How about 500 I don't kill you?
How about 575 and I don't kill you?
How about 300 and you can have every single piece of gold that we find in these? You can loot every single body. You can have whatever you would like.
And we'll make the druid drag him out to you.
Tell you what. It won't cost you anything if, and only if, you give me everything you loot from in there. everything.
What?
And I'll take off
a grand.
There's something good in here. He knows there's something in here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He knows there's something good in here.
He's got advanced knowledge.
Portion of what we find, and we determine what we give him.
5%?
We choose what we choose. If it's something important to our mission,
we keep.
We keep, and then you can have everything else.
So you're telling me you're going to take one item and give me everything else?
We have dibs.
Are you telling us that there's only one item that's going to be worth
it? I'm asking.
We have dibs, and then if it's something we don't want,
sure,
you're welcome to have.
Dibs.
Now,
how about we have dibs on the one that we need, and you can have the rest? I think that's pretty fair.
So you're winning agreements with that?
Wait a minute, wait. Before I
verbally say
that
aloud.
Should we do one item each, and we give him the rest? Like, you get an item.
Well, that means he gets last choice.
Yeah.
That's not really that good of a deal.
That's not really a deal at all.
All right,
I'm just thinking just in case there's more than one thing that we need.
We each get to keep something. He gets first choice, but he can't pick something that's relevant to our mission in being here. Like, if we come here to, you know, get a magic orb of making forever snow, we're obviously here to destroy that, so we're not going to turn around and give it to him so he can make more forever
snow. Guys, we're here to do one thing, that's kill a god.
Yeah.
That?
Yeah, but what if he takes that one item and needs to kill the god?
Well, then he joins our party because he's eternally locked to us.
As long as I'm being paid, if you consider that eternal.
Well, let me just tell you a little story. long time ago, I traded a ring.
Hang on. What's the agreement? Because there's a lot going on.
Yeah.
We choose one thing and you get the rest.
No! He's giving a story.
He's going to shake.
You choose one thing for all of you.
No. Nope.
No.
One thing only and then you get the rest.
What?
One thing only and you get the rest. Yeah. Agreement.
All right.
With yogurt.
Yogurt!
Did you agree with this? I'm on the fence.
I'll let it.
Lord Albert Shaw, you've been really quiet recently. Are we doing the right thing?
Did you see that, or
we'll find out?
Did my character see that?
No.
No. Okay.
What did you?
This is gonna get real fun real fast.
Great, you two are gonna go at it again. No matter what character you are, you guys have to fight.
Well, you know, never trust a thief.
Will you guys just
never trust guys with beards?
Just get a room.
Never trust guys with beards.
So, you guys gonna enter?
Sure. Why not?
That's what she said.
Cautiously.
That's what she said.
All right, you don't disguise your entrance.
That's what she said.
That's what she said.
Can I cast Pass Without Trace?
That's what she said.
You can.
I would like to cast Pass Without Trace.
That's what she said.
What does Pass Without Trace do, Bobby?
The Walk of Shame.
Oh, it's the Walk of Shame. Okay.
It's gonna make
it doesn't leave tracks, and it makes them easier to hide.
That's what she said.
Holy hell.
So, you guys enter. You don't come in hostily or like you're trying to.
Wasn't that funny?
I don't know.
Yeah,
that's what she said. We come in not hostily.
Yeah.
That's kind of funny.
We come in kind of flaccid.
All right. Come on.
That's what she said. Yeah.
Come on!
All right, so we come in. Really, guys? What are we, like six?
I am a barbarian here.
As we walk into this entrance.
You come in, you see the first few rooms obviously show signs that someone's inhabiting.
Yeah.
It wasn't intended to be like a habitat, but you see that they've thrown up, made makeshift fires. There's areas where they put lean-tos to block the wind. And as you come in, you can see around the outskirts, there's a few different rooms that branch out in this part of the passage. And you see many eyes. There's probably about 21 people with spears, a few with bows. They're all like huddled in the corners just staring as you're watching. They all have their spears and bows raised.
Yes.
Can I make a speech? Do you want to make a speech?
Are they going to understand your speech?
Sure.
Should I check for history?
Or dialect?
So we know what the hell we're doing?
Friend!
You know what this means?
All they see is that big
me.
Black hand.
As they release the arrow straight into your chest.
Friend! And I will... Oh, God.
Turn to a bear that usually works perfectly.
I can look up history, you know? We can find out what we're dealing with.
Don't you have arcane knowledge or something?
Yeah, I have arcane, I have history, I have religion, anything.
Roll.
Says after he says friend 7 times.
friend!
roll. This isn't working, you should roll.
Alright, what do you think?
No one's responding.
I guess arcane would be probably the best out of all this in history.
Can I? Ooh.
10? With what? Wisdom? Or intelligence? What is it? Wisdom or intelligence?
What are you trying to do? History? Or what are you
I guess arcane would be best.
I have an idea.
Or
what happens? Go do the roll, then I'm going to tell you what I'm about to do.
Would you get with your intelligence?
I get 10, 15.
All right. These are the Acerulians, the people that invaded the town. They seem...
Your peoples.
They normally are very aggressive, so the fact that they are defensive seems surprising. The other thing you notice... is out of this room and the two branching rooms that you can see in through the tunnels, yeah. You don't see a single child or woman.
Oh, so interesting. So
they kill box. I'm going to reach into my equipment and pull out the bone statuette and put it right down in the middle and go, gift.
Bone statue, what?
Gift. Mm. That we got from the...
Why are you talking to them like they're like... Aboriginal creatures.
Well, they kind of are.
He's his people. If we can understand him, they understand us.
Well, they understand him.
But we understand him.
Well, he can speak common, yeah.
Yeah, he's speaking our language, but he has to speak their language.
Translate friend and gift.
I'm not there.
Yeah, that's right.
No, he's outside. No, he's outside.
Oh, that's right.
Oh,
I ask, is there one among you you count as a leader?
If they don't understand
after language, you hear some grumbling, and then you see... very strong, muscular, scarred individual step forward.
Muscular scars.
And he's like, our men have been defeated. You have reclaimed your village, but why do you come to our holy place?
The storms will not cease. We need to pass.
Pass where?
Yes.
Not you know important. Thinking, we just need to get through the storm, and we can't do that unless it stops.
That's all we want to
and
get through.
What do you want from us?
Safe passage.
We've heard rumors that the cause of the storm is in this holy place.
The witches, they commune with the gods that bring us this weather. We are the perfect hunter in this weather. It is meant to be a gift from our God.
Well, we are a gift from your God. Where would your God be?
Did your wife
say
last night?
Where would we locate this God?
But we're willing to allow you passage if you will do something for us.
What?
Get us a shrubbery.
Our families have been taken by the witches. To maintain their control over us.
The same witches.
13 years ago, a party passed through the same tomb, and they slew the witches. The witches just recently came back within the last year, and to secure their hold over the tribe, they stole all our children and women. You free them and secure their safety, then we will let you pass, as they will have no power over our tribe any longer.
Okay.
Consider it done.
Wow. Yep.
Where are the witches now?
Do we have to kill Hutzel's sister finally?
The witches are deep. We cannot allow you to go to where the witches are, but we will guide you where they hold our families.
All right.
If we release your families, you're pretty sure the witches will follow because they will sense.
The witches are in the inner cavern. Or the witch that came back from the town. She retreated into the inner caverns to speak with our deity.
The deity have a name?
Yes, he does.
Frank.
Our deity's name is Tachadel.
Chester Copperpot.
His hand looks just like this!
All right, let's free your people. free your mind.
They bring you.
The rest will follow.
They bring you to a passage, and you go deeper. They don't. They are you just gonna stay outside?
Yeah. Wait a minute. We gotta get this guy in here. He's gonna see all his buddies.
He doesn't want to go in there because he's a traitor.
I'm an outcast. They don't like me. I don't like them.
You walk in there, just give him the finger.
Yeah.
You come in. They don't particularly. They're not surprised that you guided them here, because they were shocked that these outlanders would be able to navigate their master's storm as well as they did. None of them talk to you, but they don't necessarily make any aggressive actions. They lead you to a passage that goes deeper into another section of the tomb, and you pass through into an antechamber with a beautifully crafted stone statue of a graceful elven man with his arms outstretched to the heavens. A doorway out of this room is blocked by a sheet of ice, framed by ice sculptures of scantily clad women holding the ice up.
Nice.
Surrounding the perimeter of the room are small impish ice sculptures bowing to the center statue.
Can I find my elven cloak?
The elven cloak is not actually a Harry Potter cloak. It allows you to get advantage on stealth in a natural environment.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
The natural environment.
You can deal with it too.
Yeah. Is the deal still on, or what are we doing with that? Because obviously I'm not watching the door anymore.
Nope. We lost the deal.
All right. So it goes back to the original terms.
So. We got a guy to make a religion check, a history check, and an archaeology check. Is there anything we can tell about this architecture, guys?
I'll do a history check. As you guys are looking around, you can see the movement in this room, and there's kind of like dim light throughout the entire tomb. Like the walls seem icy, and they seem almost translucent, like the caught light that kind of like flows through the passages.
So there's something beyond.
But as you're moving, you can see shadows come up to the wall of ice. Yeah, and you can see that they're about dwarven size. They're like only like 3 feet high. Then you see more and more huddled to the wall of ice and like press against it.
I would like to start.
Your people are
starting. No, I'm just going to light like five torches and kind of scatter them forward just against the walls.
You put them against the wall. You see on the other side of that ice wall is a group of children and women. And they're huddled on the other side of that wall of ice.
Well, I know what we got to do, folks.
Smash with sword.
Berserker barrage.
But they're frozen in ice.
No, they're not frozen. They're behind ice.
They're behind a wall of ice.
Yeah, they're like, help us.
Are they? Can we hear them? Are they just screaming? But it's
no, they're just yeah. You can't hear anything. You can just see them pushing against the ice wall.
Everybody, stand back, Brian. Bust up thunder.
It's like being at Sea World.
No, I'll ring around it.
I could do. A flaming sphere which is melted.
I'll ring a ram it.
You gonna ring a ram it?
Yeah, sure.
All right. You sure? You sure? Much like melt? We can melt
the. I know. All the children inside this.
If I did flaming sphere, couldn't I just melt a hole in the?
Does it look like there's like a
We're
door?
We're in a tomb made of
no,
ice.
No, it's like a doorway. But like I said, there's two ice sculptures of women that kind of like they have their arms like this, holding, and in the archway is just a wall of ice. Coming from those two sculptures.
Break the sculptures first.
I'm just gonna make a decision right now.
Let's kill the sculptures first.
I'm gonna ring a ram the head off of one of the sculptures.
Oh.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes. Done.
You do that.
Done. It's done.
Done.
Go.
Yes. He has to decapitate one.
But while you do that, can you thunderwave the other one at the same time?
What, a double whammy?
Yeah, let's go for it. Ready?
All right. All right.
Ready?
Well, using thunderwave, you can probably hit
them both. One, Three. Well, I mean, it's you don't really have to roll for this.
Yeah, you don't have to roll for
this. You're only going to dodge.
Yeah.
All right, so
the sculpture jumps out of the way.
Each of you launches a burst of energy, and you see both the statues kind of like shatter, and you see the ice wall kind of like cracks out like fingers. Roll initiative.
Magically created ice.
11.
So we have 11 for Gazal. What do we have for you?
20.
20 for Albert. What do we have for Kiner?
12.
What do you have, Chester?
What's that from?
8. Yeah, it's just a random.
I know.
Final Fantasy.
And Miles?
Oh, that's what 14. It is.
I said, if these boxes, if this was like a little higher, you could stack them, then you'd have something.
Oh, no, my battery's
getting
off.
So, what?
Yeah, like if this was like
hey, man,
up to here.
We got it up there, that's all that mattered.
In the box like that, and had the same holding slots, and you could stack the box on top of each other.
Oh, they stack up fairly well this way. But
yeah,
yeah,
you know
I know
yeah.
what you're thinking about or thought about.
I thought
about
like a little tiny groove.
Two people. Stuff.
Like, yeah. So it would be like fit the little things in there.
I was thinking about doing like,
like a tiny groove kind of thing?
Yeah, two sets of like nesting trays.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice.
But that would just take way too much time. I mean, literally, I made these are chintzy rough cut on the bandsaw, and it took me literally a month to make these.
Jay, can you cut my hair?
Yeah.
Wow.
Right now?
For the bandsaw?
No, just, dude. Yeah. Hey, look at this.
Yeah, you have hair.
Want to cut it?
Go to a barber.
No, I don't have any fan. Yeah.
He wants,
do you have a electric razor?
I think so. I think I still have one.
You'll be like, you like a while you'll like Joker from Arkham Knight games.
Right up,
with right? That hair.
Like guy from like.
You should dye it before you shave it off.
Okay.
Like Doc Brown when he was younger or something.
Marty.
Olympians.
We gotta get plutonium from Olympians.
It's about your mother.
It's not you. It's something we've done about your kids.
You gotta hear this band. They got a great new monster sound. Anyway, sorry, I was the wrong guy, but it's my favorite part of that movie.
Wait, what are we doing now? John's rolling for the.
John's rolling for the evil thing that's gonna attack.
Okay, us. As you do this to the wall, you see, like. You see the explosion of ice, and as you guys are focusing on the wall, you see the statue in the center kind of, its arms just go, and they start cracking. You see like the rime of ice that's formed on the outside of the statue kind of crack off, and the thing walks off its pedestal.
What?
Everyone make a wisdom saving throw.
You must be the Michelin Man.
Crap.
13.
I'm toast.
18.
What are we plusing?
Plus the whatever your wisdom bonus.
Oh, plus wisdom.
15.
0.
So I'm still
18. 0.
15.
22.
And you?
I had a 10.
Plus right. Wisdom.
The three of you, you feel this wave of cold go over you, and you've been slowed.
Whoa. No. What do we do? We're in slow motion, Scooby.
Okay, the first one to move is
can
Albert.
Can I have used evasion?
No.
Can't evade.
Uncanny dodge?
Nope.
Albert.
What about a cunning action?
Nope.
So it's just me and the puntable dwarf that are in full motion.
Well, you guys can move.
Yeah.
The only difference is your speed is halved. You can't use reactions. And if you make an attack action, you only get one attack. You don't get your full attack.
So no three attack there, Lord Albert Shaw.
Well, wait a minute. This thing is a giant animated statue, right?
Ice.
God.
No, it's a stone statue. It had ice covering it.
Oh.
All right, then I'm going to use Shatter.
Okay.
Well, if my reading of the description of the spell is correct, it should have a penalty against saving throws against it.
Nice.
When'd you get spells?
He's Lord Albert Shaw.
A long time ago.
Yeah.
All right, roll your damage.
Okay, 3d8.
Come on now.
So.
Look at Amy.
You're a good rogue. You
only got a dagger.
Three of these.
And a crossbow.
You're a good rogue.
How do I find a statue guy?
And let him
how big is this guy?
Statue is the size of an elf.
Oh.
It had a pedestal that made it higher in the room than you, but it stepped off its pedestal, so it's only like 5'8".
Oh my god. We can take this thing.
12 damage total.
Alright, you can see a few little cracks appear, but it continues moving. And after that, You see the little bowing ice sculptures along the wall. One of them breaks free from the wall, kind of shakes around a little.
Ooh. How big are these things?
These guys are about 3 feet tall. Oh. And
well, did any of them get hit with the shatter? Because it's a radius effect.
Yeah, but they're all on the walls it's okay. around it, and you targeted the guy in the middle of the room. He comes and swings at Kazaa, the little creature. You can hear it talking to itself. It's like, oh, I don't know, you're not quite sure what it's saying.
It's swinging a shillelagh around.
And it's swinging its icy claws at you.
Is it asking me a question? Should I ask?
Saint Baservus.
Then you see another one break off from the other side of the wall and come over to you, Kiner. And
boot in the face.
Yeah, you're right.
It hit you for 3 points of damage.
Wait, it hit you?
Yes, it hit me.
But didn't do anything to me.
It missed you.
You had a bad roll.
3 points of damage?
3 points of damage.
That's not a lot.
That is not a lot.
These things are a little pesky.
These are nuisance things. Oh, you guys get this.
And then we go to Miles.
Mr. Carver.
All right. Mm. I turn towards the wall of ice.
It's rock.
No,
oh,
wall of ice. Wall of ice. People are behind.
Okay. Why would you free them now?
Because that's all we need to do.
That's not going to stop the statues from attacking them, though.
That's what I'm saying.
We'll see. I can't do anything to help you with this. It's stone and little stone creatures. I have nothing that can help.
No, they're
you
little
with
ice creatures.
I know, but I can't help you with anything.
You said they were made of stone.
Free them.
No, don't the free statues them. Made of stone. The you're little creatures are made
them.
Of ice.
Are you saying we free them and run?
I take the people and get out, and I get them to safety, and then we deal with the rest of the people.
Well, thanks for sharing the plan with us now. Go ahead.
Come on, think about it.
Go.
I just had it in my head too, and Brian distracted me with this stupid thing. I'd break the ice.
With what?
I had it in my head, and Brian.
He was all like, think.
Yeah.
Nope.
Hey, you know how much a polar bear weighs? Just enough to break the ice. I might respond.
Oh.
Right, fine then, Mr. Hero Boy. I will
hero.
Kick. One of the little short rounds in the head.
No, I want you.
Nope, kick one of the short rounds in the head.
I want
kick
you
one of the short rounds in the head.
The woman and children.
Hitting one of the short rounds in the head because Bobby's a jerk.
Wow.
Wow. Okay.
All right, attack it.
Steered you the wrong way. That's great.
Are you attacking one of the guys anyway. That's attacking the party?
Yes, one of the short rounds.
All right.
17.
Okay, what are you attacking?
Just the sword. I have a long sword.
What, your dagger?
It says I have a long sword.
No, well, you can attack with your long sword.
This is your proficiencies. You can have that.
Oh, okay.
But your
gotcha.
Weapons that you actually have.
I got you. Shut up.
There. See, there's one that's actually called Frostbrand. You don't want to use that.
Gee, thanks, Captain Obvious.
Because you don't want to use the magical sword that does cold damage against ice creatures.
Mm-hmm. Yes. That's right.
I will hit it with a.
Your best shot.
Crossbow.
This one's getting low, so I'm gonna stop it.
Goodbye.
All right. If you attack one of the ones attacking the party, you get sneak attack.
Okay.
Which person do you want to help, Kiner or Kazaa?
Kiner. Fill him money. So 17 plus 9 is the 26.
Good.
And then.
Good reward.
1d6 plus 3.
Ooh,
is
9.
And then.
You need some more, buddy?
Nah, you're good. Shut up. I'm not talking to you right now.
What? What's wrong?
11. Eight, 19.
Is the TV going?
19 no. plus.
Oh my god, Bobby, that was a long video.
What? What now?
No, you started recording from here, and then I had it going. It was a little long one.
Alright, how much?
What number 19 plus 23 is?
19 plus 23.
Well, let's see, that's going to be 42.
Yeah.
And you're helping Kiner?
Yeah. Pop that little fucker like a.
Make a dexterity save?
Like a daisy? Ooh.
8 total?
Total.
You slip on some ice.
You take 2 points of damage. You come in, and as you shoot it, it explodes into a swarm of like sharp, jagged ice things, and
one
then
hits me in the arm.
Yeah, one nicks you in the arm, and it's gone.
I was concerned that these things are not more powerful.
And then it is Kiner's turn.
Are they though?
Yeah.
I feel like they are.
There. Any more little creatures coming out of the walls?
I'm concerned that we're in
there's one attacking
situation where we may actually be slaughtering women and children, which would suck.
That's why I didn't want the kids to take them out. But they're not yet. You didn't break the ice.
Nope. I'm just going to start smashing the ones on the walls before they start turning.
Okay.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
All right. Let's start attacking.
Honestly, all that's right. The best
first idea. Attack is 17, second, 19.
Yeah.
Yep.
4.
11, 6, no, 4 and 6, 6 is 10 plus, 10. So it's 15 for the first attack.
I'm fighting the main statue in the center.
15, 4. So 15 for a first attack, 9 for the second attack.
It's made of
there you go.
So all right, give me a dexterity save. Objects, maybe
acid or... I've seen you.
Oh, wow.
You had a 1. What's your plus?
Oh, yeah, dex is so.
Yeah, if you roll a 1, you failed.
Yeah.
You take 7 points of damage. The thing explodes into a shatter of ice.
Got a piece of glass in your eye.
Apparently.
Okay. After that, Kazaa.
Well, acid arrow, maybe.
Yeah. I'm going to use my old trusty acid arrow.
On what?
On Stony.
Okay, roll.
Stony Stonington.
I'm going to turn into polar bear. 4d4?
I'm going to turn into polar bear the stem.
I'm going to turn into a fluffy bear. Scare all the children.
Do I have to roll 4 of these?
Well, does it say you have to roll the hit? Or
it says hit 4d4/2d4.
All right, we'll roll the hit. The d20 to hit. The other one's for the damage.
20.
All right, so you roll, what was the damage?
4d4.
So you roll
8d4. 8d4. 8? Wow.
You got a critical hit with your bolt 3. Of acid.
Hold on, I got you, buddy. There.
Wait, 4 of these? Thank you. Ah, nice. All right, there we go.
What's the tsunami of acid just shoots from his hand? Papa needs a new acid arrow.
Yahtzee.
Wow.
Oh, all right. 3, 6.
Is this all the ones that it's supposed to be?
Yeah.
So this is 6, that's 10, 11, 13, 15.
And I think that's it.
6, yeah.
And I think that does continuous damage every turn, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's a mad dash for the D4s.
Yeah.
All right, there is a, you've sprayed acid and it's starting to, like, you can see this, like, This white thick smoke as it's like eating off the top layer of his stone.
Oh, nice.
Is it like that scene in Raiders of the Lost Ark when the Nazi starts melting?
It's similar, except if the Nazi was made out of pure stone.
Aren't they all? Anyway.
And after that, another little creature breaks off from the wall and tries to hit you, Bobby, but fails.
Good.
After that.
Is it afraid of the D?
Is Chester.
All right. protection from energy. That's any sort of element, right?
Yeah, if someone tried to use elemental.
You should just meld with stone and explode out of his chest.
Oh my god, yes!
It doesn't work that way.
No. It would be awesome if it did.
I can cast out
myself. He is not Neo at the end of the Matrix.
Do it!
Can I cast out myself or can I cast on the party?
Protection.
Sorry, I'm asking all the hard-hitting questions. Nixon.
Is it really using any kind of energy-based attack, though, so far?
I gotta buy a manual so I can help you out with this crap.
Well, here, take mine.
Really?
Jeremy's been holding a manual the whole time.
Oh,
that's why I've been using it to look up my spells.
Oh, it's so warm.
He's been sitting on it. And farting.
Protection from energy. One person. The one person you can touch has resistance to one damage type of your choice. Acid, cold, fire, lightning,
how
or thunder.
How long does it
last? Dude, 1 hour, but it's concentration. Melting the shit out of this guy.
So you have to maintain concentration, you get hit, you have to maintain it.
I'm going to cast protection on ice on myself.
Yeah. Okay.
Gotcha. That's what I'm doing for my turn. It's the end. And then I'm saying some cunning remark. Next!
Okay,
You're gonna get it.
You've got it. The statue moves right towards the person that sprayed acid at him.
Uh-oh.
Walking past the warrior, but the warrior can't take an attack opportunity because of the coat of ice that's slowing him down.
Yeah, because we're still in motion right now.
You can make another save against wisdom
at
the end of your turn to see if the slow ended.
Oh, only I didn't remember your
realm.
When
do we get to make saves?
Then your turn.
Five. Okay. I did not.
You want to make one? You went.
Enzio.
It's a 19 or 16?
16. 16. Be a 91.
16. Okay, you're no longer slowed.
You rolled 91.
I didn't realize that. Yeah. I'm not slow anymore. But I know. I'm 91.
Not slowed.
I'm still slow. I'm still slow. I know. I like that name.
He had like
Lone?
Four of them. Did
Mike
you hear
Warren?
That?
Did you hear that show though?
Yeah, I listened to
he had like four of them.
I know.
But
he
like totally no idea.
That was a good one.
That was a great one. Yeah, that actually was really good. Even the beginning where Rocky was talking about his now new girlfriend.
His catfishing?
Yep.
I like his random stories. That was interesting.
He hits you twice with, you know, like he's about your same stature. He hits you with his stony fists. Both stony connect. Fist. You can feel the bones cracking under it. You take 41 points of damage from his two punches.
Oh, fuck me.
You got Thunderstruck.
Where the fuck?
He just got
74 minus 41.
All right, Albert.
You know what would really be funny? You should really not join our podcast.
At the end of my turn, correct?
Chat.
All right.
And be a part of the Rocky versus John ongoing battles.
I'm going to have
Facebook.
One of my three
attacks. It's quite hilarious. You engage him.
Oh, he'll keep going.
That's hilarious. Why I stop. I just go, okay, and I just.
But John's like the guy that loves engaging.
But John likes to engage.
Like, I just keep going.
It's like a whole day goes by. And it's just like John.
I did
Rocky,
hockey
John,
last
Rocky.
Night.
I only talk to him when I'm on the can at before, work. So like, I log on and I fucking talk shit for a while. And
while
then I go back to my desk.
You talk shit while you're taking a shit.
Yeah.
Last night I was doing hockey. Or was it might have been today at work.
I'm gonna use one of my down, three attacks
back.
For
25
a
messages.
You only get one attack.
Between John and Rocky.
And you get no bonus actions.
Arguing about nothing.
Well, no, I thought instead of one.
Nope.
Can I attack?
Not while you're slowed.
Oh.
You get one attack, so you get no extra attacks, and you either get an action or a bonus action, not both.
Okay, I forgot that also. Yeah, you're right.
You have a nice thin layer of ice over your body right now, and it creaks as you're moving.
Alright, so then I'll just use Acid Splash, which is
2d6,
save for half.
Man.
What?
I'm going to use Acid Splash on the statue.
You really like the acid, don't you?
Well, acid's kicking its ass.
It's an inanimate object. I don't know how else we're going to hurt it.
Well, you can attack it. You have magical weapons.
We can tickle its feet.
That's true.
Hey, Bobby.
Yes, sir.
Isn't your character
smack
up in the stone?
Plus five
now, is that
reaching
an automatic hit? Because I don't see a plus modifier for hit. It just says 2d6.
Since you're such a smooth
yeah, just
criminal over there.
Splash 2d6. I think they get a saving throw.
Yeah, save. It takes
that'd be awesome
half.
If you just like jumped into it.
Three.
Meld into stone.
I still think you should jump into it.
Yeah, that transition to a creature and bust it all apart.
Yeah, it's a rock.
You step into a stone object or surface large enough to fully contain your body, melding yourself and all the equipment you carry with the stone.
Yeah.
Using your movement, you step into stone at a point you can touch. Nothing of your presence remains visible. It will merge with the stone. You can't see what occurs outside. You can't.
Yeah.
And with wisdom checks, you can hear sounds but made with disadvantage. You remain aware of passage of time.
Yeah.
And you can cast spells on yourself while merged in the stone. You can use your movement to leave the stone. Minor physical damage to the stone doesn't harm you. But it is partial destruction or a change in its shape expels you and deals 66 bludgeoning damage to you.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say meld with the stone and turn into like a polar bear.
Yeah, yeah. It might be worthwhile.
I can't, no, guys, I can't.
It would damage him, no. Not
I know, I know.
It would be funny as watch, though.
All right.
You have 87 points of damage. You have like 20 points of damage after that. What's the
deal? Wait, let me get this straight.
It would take a nap for like a day and you're fine.
You want me to
Yes, we do.
Okay, crawl
whatever you say,
stuff.
Bobby, that's what we want you to do.
Mm-hmm. It's not going to damage the creature.
Yeah, it won't. It won't do any damage
when
to
you
it.
Explode out of it.
Can you tell these morons that there's no way that that's going to work?
No, it won't work. It won't.
You won't change the shape of the stone?
You change it to a dragon.
Who is the stone expert here?
You.
Thank you.
So I did 3
who's
points
the wimpy
of
stone guy?
Damage to it.
Mm-hmm.
Roll for my save?
I don't want to touch the stone.
Your what?
My save?
Yep.
Okay. I don't want to do it. But you can't break the glass because the people come out.
Okay. I'm going to use I got a 4, so I'm going to use my Indomitable class feature to reroll that saving throw.
Okay.
Believe it or not, I actually wanted you to free them and just make a roll for it.
Then why'd you say the thing about the polar bear thing?
It's Constitution, yes?
No, I didn't say anything.
He did. Wisdom. I could turn into a polar bear.
I got a 16.
I never said anything about polar bear.
Oh, come on!
Where's
I never said anything about polar bear.
All right, you two make deck saves. You two make death saves.
I guarantee
me
you.
Me and him?
Yep.
Death save? Was that
no, not death saves. Death saves.
But you said, you know, or if someone could turn into a polar bear.
What am I processing?
Your deck saves.
That wasn't me. That was not me.
15.
11.
Actually wanted you to.
All right, you both take 3 points of cold damage.
I usually listen to you. So you say something like that, I know not to do.
Get ready.
The little ice sprite.
He opens
up his mouth that grows wide, and he sprays out frost and ice all over the two
really?
Of you.
God. Yeah, I gotta melt these little bastards.
So biting.
I'm
gonna do maybe Thunderwave.
Okay, now it is Miles' turn.
I'm gonna do a flaming spear on the little ice guy.
Okay, so.
So, you have any of these little ice dudes are left?
There's 2. There's 1 attacking Chester and 1.
I ain't doing so hot, guys.
Next
I'm at 30 hips up.
You'll be fine, sir.
Okay. I come running up behind the little one behind on Brian and just.
Crack up on that little guy?
Because Bobby can deal with what he's got going on. 17 plus 10 is 27.
Okay.
Plus 1 is 28. And it's a sneak attack. So 10 for the piercing. Plus 6, 7.
It's going to be very hard for me to make this saving throw.
Yep.
18 plus what did I say before? 46.
All right, make a deck save.
Saving throw, plus 8 magic ability modifier? 14. What is my armor's ability again?
Okay, that is enough. You are that quick enough to avoid the ice shards.
Yeah.
As it blows up.
Mm-hmm.
Yay!
What?
Then we go to the next. Kiner.
Woohoo!
There is 1 of the ice creatures attacking Chester.
I will take it
and keep getting hit. Then you have these 2 over next to the stone statue of the elf,
who is
bruised and bloodied, the wizard.
I already took one out, though, didn't I?
I'm talking about the statue. You're taking out the little guys, yeah.
I'm going to use my reckless attack on the statue.
Okay.
Nice.
So, yeah.
You are not slowed, so you can use both attacks. And you have advantage, so roll twice for each attack.
Take each attack.
All right, here we go.
However, if it hits you, it gets
roll. Advantage. Okay. What's that? No, nothing.
Nothing. Yeah. Nothing happened.
No, oh, next. Yeah, the other roll. It. The other roll. Nice. 11. 11 plus.
Oh, what the hell did you just say?
Wait, hold on. You're using what? Your raging attack? Plus 9. So 12.
Well, are you raging?
No, I'm just using the reckless.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, so plus 9, what?
I don't know. Did that count towards raging?
No, it's not unless right. you use your
so reckless. So it's just plus 5.
Okay, so.
Reckless.
No. Yeah, keep on going.
Yeah, the plus hit is the
yeah,
first.
Yeah, so it's this one, greatsword.
Yeah, so
yeah.
Plus 9.
Yeah.
Plus 9.
Okay, so that hits. So roll 2 more dice for the second attack.
No. Nope. And roll that one again?
Jeremy.
11 plus the 9, so 12.
Okay, so you get 2 hits. Which you both would have missed if you weren't recklessly attacking.
Yeah. Correctly. 2d6 plus 5.
I want to see.
Or you can just do 4d6 plus 10.
Oh, good.
You ready to go to like max downtown or something. I'm going to gouge you for a steak, man.
Here you go. One more.
Mr. Arden, so you turn into a polar bear?
2, 4.
Did he not say he wanted to turn into a polar bear and break the ice?
No, that was a joke.
How much? But you looked at me like you were serious.
Okay.
I said, hey, how much does a polar bear weigh?
Mm-hmm.
I could
just that enough to break the ice.
Was that one of the little guys?
Stone statue. Make me think so you were going to break the ice?
I was beating the crap out of Kazay.
No. No, sir. It wouldn't. That was a joke.
It would be facetious.
Not only that, but it's a very commonly known joke. Yes, because
in
it was...
In the D&D community, that's well known. It's a huge joke. They use it all the time. Yes,
I can name it in a movie featuring Owen Wilson.
What movie?
Well, no one's seen that because no one watches Owen Wilson movies.
Wrong. Okay, because
live tweet Owen Wilson right now. Tell those movies suck.
Live tweet him? Stop with the live tweeting people.
I will.
the little bastard, the little icicle bastard. I was thinking about doing a flaming sphere in an area that would probably hit as many of these little bastards as I could.
Shouldn't you just run and hide somewhere?
You're face to face with the stone statue.
It just punched you for 31 damage.
You walk away from it without disengaging, it will get an attack opportunity.
Oh, I thought the last time I got hit was by a little icicle guy.
No, icicle guys don't hit like that. They hit like,
the icicle stuff out of his mouth.
That was the last guy you got hit.
Yeah.
But he hit you for 4 points of damage or whatever, and the other guy hit you for 40.
All right. Sorry.
So you basically have to fight the big giant.
Aren't you Thunderwave the big guy?
I don't really know if a Thunderwave is gonna push him back. Help him. I'm gonna do Acid Arrow again because I took up a lot of damage.
Oh my god, you and the Acid Arrows.
It works. Me and Huttle are hitting with acid.
You need to get away from the thing.
What's Disintegrate?
What is Disintegrate?
Well,
cast Disintegrate. Sounds like a fire spell on the big guy.
Probably the most powerful spell he has, but I don't know that.
Yeah.
It's made of stone, so it might be resistant.
Disintegrating?
Well, yeah. Disintegration is still a fire-based element.
May I?
Yeah.
Do you want to cast Disintegrate?
Yeah. Hold on. Is it actually going to work?
Bobby's checking.
Yeah, let's make sure this is...
Let's tell the stone guy to...
We have to reference the Junior Woodchuck Handbook over here.
We check our spells. It's like an episode of Gravity Falls.
To the book. Make a wooden dowel. Disintegrate. A thin green ray springs from your pointing finger that you can cast. Creature targeted by the spell must make a dexterity saving throw. Mm-hmm. On a failed save, the target takes 10d6 plus 40 force damage, not ice damage. If this damage reduces the target to zero, it is disintegrated. A disintegrated creature and everything it is carrying, except for magical items, are reduced to a pile of fine-grade dust.
This is not a creature, this is a rock guy.
It's a creature.
A rock creature!
This spell automatically disintegrates a large or smaller non-magical object or a creation of magical force.
Give it a shot.
You cast the spell using a spell slot of 7 or higher, which you can't, anyway.
Yeah.
I would do it. Go.
Alright,
failed save.
We just went through 6 hours of blizzard noise.
That was a lot of blizzard noise.
So, if I'm looking at this right.
The drippy, drappy.
I think that's what was making me a little tired. Don't roll yet.
I kind of missed the noise, though.
Does the character have to do a fail save on it? It says, because it says here on a failed save, the target takes. So you don't have to roll, you have to roll, right?
Yeah, you don't have to roll the hit.
Oh, roll the hit, go.
I don't have to roll.
Nope.
It's an automatic hit, you just roll for damage.
You're going to point your finger and blast some green shit. What do you do? Show us.
I'm going to blast some green shit right in its face.
Are you going to say anything while you do it?
I'm going to go, icky, sticky, dicky, doom.
Excellent.
Yes.
At least he didn't say bibbity bobbity.
That's what I was thinking of.
Roll 10d6.
Roll 10d6.
10d2. Oh, Jesus. 4.
And that's how you burn up your spell slot, buddy.
Just roll those twice.
10d6. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Chester.
You're welcome. 8.
Oh, my lord. Oh my Lanta.
Lord. 9.
Have mercy.
And one more. Wow.
Also roll 2d4. Roll 2d4 quick.
2d4.
The lingering acid from your Mel's acid.
I'll roll that for you. Got it.
Where's mine?
That's 5 damage.
Okay. No, 2d4.
I got you. 2d4.
I
you got two. No, it's already too late. All right, roll it. Fire.
All right, roll the 10d6.
Yeah, he's not going to do better than 5.
All right.
5 out of 8? Please.
Is anybody interested in the full house porno?
Yes.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
Yeah. I think it's creepy.
For real? It's very creepy. That's why I'm into it.
Dude, full house of porno.
Oh man.
God. It's like full holes.
On my room. On my room. I delivered to a porn shop. I got to check it out.
And it's on Pornhub Premium.
Ooh. How do you, are you on premium?
I saw the trailer you posted.
You're on premium.
It's on the trailer.
You're on premium.
Well, that's pay paying for porn. What do you mean?
You're a premium member.
Supposedly it's coming to Netflix.
I still have your account.
It really is.
April.
15.
Also, there's the month
today. April. How?
Netflix.
No, they're not. All right, what do you got?
He keeps
40.
Plus 40, so you did 80 points of damage.
Yay!
Wow.
You see, like, the stone just like slowly stripping away as the creature becomes smaller and smaller.
So it hits you hard, and you hit it back harder. Way to go.
Hazard.
And it retaliates by hitting you back.
It's like a magical slug. Who's these? Sludge match.
This one's.
Slug.
Please.
Slobberknocker.
Slobberknocker. How tall is he?
Slobber.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Wait. What did it hit
Hold
me?
Hold on. We'll find out. Shh. You're getting ass raped right now. Hold on.
Now I already got 30. So.
He's bending you over like a 2 cent hooker in.
In Russia.
Wherever. Jenna's gonna look at his face like you're about to die.
Alright, you are knocked unconscious. You are dying.
Oh, jeez.
How much damage?
42 this time. Oh. Which brings you down to negative 12.
Negative 12.
Oh, but God. That doesn't really matter once you're negative. You're dead.
You're not dead. He
unleashed his power and the thing just responded and kept beating him. You can hear some bones snapping as he gets like barraged by the
berserker barrage
of stone.
Yeah.
And after that is Albert. That,
I'll take care of our wizard. You just keep on fighting, dude.
Full holes.
Nice. All right. No, wait a minute. Chester, sorry. Chester goes first.
I'm going to heal. I let's see. What can I do here? I mean, heal's a real spell, but I think that's a little bit too powerful. Maybe. C, D, E, F. E, F, G, H. Sorry, guys. Spell books.
We should all have one.
Yeah, I'm going to buy one, guys.
So much fun. All right. You guys buy them and I'll just read yours.
Heal. Choose a creature that you can see within range. A surge of positive energy washes through the creature, causing it to regain 70 hit points. This spell also ends blindness, deafness, and any diseases affecting the target.
So it'd bring him from 0 to 70.
What? How many hit points do you normally have?
74.
74.
Do it. Boom. Wow. You're alive.
All of a sudden, you feel a surge of energy, and now you, like, most of your wounds, other than a few scratches from the little ice creature that's still running around your feet. No, not you. You're the one that's running around his feet. So you just have little scratches left on your...
Aw. Thanks, Chester.
You're welcome,
I'm
buddy.
Back in action.
Now, Albert, you're up. There is the statue that just knocked Kazaa to the ground, and there is a little ice thing running around Chester trying to hit him.
Hopefully.
All right, so
this is the most powerful spells I've seen you guys use consecutively.
Hey, man.
It's two level six spells.
The book has opened our minds.
This isn't baby shit here. We're ready.
Okay, so basically, we have a giant stone statue, which I'm guessing it has its back turned to me because it's trying to stomp on Kazaa. Mm-hmm.
Well, it already did. It's fighting both of you.
Okay. So then if I tried to attack the little imp that's attacking him, I would probably get an attack of opportunity from the statue?
Yeah.
Okay. And I can only make one attack, correct?
Correct.
I need to... I guess I'll just hit it with my sword.
Okay.
Well, wait a minute. Protection.
I'm assuming you're watching the full
Protection of evil and good. Would that give me a bonus to my saving throw on the slow or no? No.
It only protects you from undead and fiends.
Alright. Well, then I guess I'll just use a normal sword attack against the statue.
I like how Rocky complained at the Unusual Twins. It's like you're complaining about a porno.
They weren't twins on the team.
17.
Show. Okay, that hits.
Okay, and that is 2d6 plus 8.
You have a character called Muff Shell.
Muff Shell.
And Uncle Jizzy.
Uncle Jizzy. I have to tell you, the new Full House looks like a Portal parody already.
I know.
Do you have shot. The chicks wearing?
Oh okay. My gosh.
It looks like Uncle Jizzy's gonna get the down.
You cack into it. Okay. It's starting to like move erratically.
Yeah.
Miles, you're up.
The Jizz Boys. All right. The Beach Boys make an appearance.
I know. I was like, what the hell are they doing?
17.
All right, you're good.
Finally.
All right, Miles, we're waiting for you.
Is there any more of those little thingies around?
Yeah, there's one trying to hit Chester.
Oh, I'll run over and try to start breaking the ice on the wall.
Thanks, man.
You really deserve it.
Man, you and I are really sprawling today.
14.
Good thing there's Pornhub.
Plus 10. Plus 1. Right, 25. There you go, sir.
Okay, roll it.
I'm going to check. If you want, I can do a movie review. Like, what's his name used to?
Oh, yeah, you should. Porn parodies?
Yeah, sure.
Oh my god, instead of Mr. Skin, it'll be called like.
Nine.
No, just Bob Watches a Movie.
Bob Watches a Movie.
What'd you do?
It's the best Bob ever. On Bob on Porn. Bob on Porn. Bob in for porn.
Daggered the wall.
No.
I like the Bob Watches
a little of the ice.
If you're serious about it, I will
What's
do it.
What's going on? You should.
Okay.
That'd be awesome.
Kiner, you're up.
Do it.
Repeat.
Okay.
Another reckless.
Rinse. Destroy.
Just come with like a name for you, though. So it's like Bob. Though.
You can just record it on your phone and send it to me as a message.
That's what I was gonna do.
19 on the first one.
Not that it's not going to be recorded now, anyways. But
11 on the second one.
You know, just come up with like some kind of alias.
Mailing it in.
No.
Mailing it in with Bobby.
Listen.
Six.
We're playing D&D right now. We'll talk about it later.
Really?
Yes.
So 7 and 1.
How much?
8.
7, 8? 1.
8.
Plus
your idea.
I don't
get
like
everyone's in the back. Oh, that's right. I about the damn plus. 8, 5.
So 13?
13.
All right. All right, your next
Isn't
attack.
Are they federal now? Because I thought they were like separate from the government.
No, I've been sworn in then.
Yeah. 6. 6, 7, 8,
9. Independent. Nah. 10, they were talking 10, about
that
a long time
14.
Ago.
14. I thought so. Okay.
Is that against the stone statue?
Yeah, they were
stone statue, yeah.
It's not going to happen.
All right, your two attacks. Cause the statue cracks, and then you see its arm falls off, and then it kind of like turns to the side, and it just like starts crumbling to pieces. As it collapses to the ground underneath it, you see the last ice creature. You see it just start like, you see its face become less distinct, and it just melts into a puddle of water.
Oh, yes.
Yay. You're a Wizard of Oz on it.
We solved your icy puzzle.
As that melts, you also see the wall between you and the other room just slowly melts in the water as well.
Oh. Yeah.
I was trying
and
to say that.
You see the all the people come out and they're like, they kind of look a little apprehensive of you. They notice you and they're like, did you come back to save our people?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes,
he did.
This man right here.
This man right
this
here.
This hero. Led us.
Asked us to help him save your people.
He wasn't paid at all.
No.
He definitely does not carry many pieces of gold.
He didn't
Please.
Ask for any money.
Embrace give your hero.
Yes, hero.
Kiner, your hero.
Your elected official.
Future king of your people.
Richard Kiner.
Richard Kiner.
What
am I, a DDS?
All right. So, after a while, they chat with Dead you Bill. And they see that they've been Dead saved. They return up to the level Bill above, yeah. And the tribe embraces them. They consider you all friends, and they forgive your old trespasses against their people. And they say, we no longer have to serve them. And they basically go near to another room, and they activate a hidden latch, which opens a way deeper into the tomb. They go, the witch retreated back this way.
Let's go kill that bitch.
And this will turn off the blizzard?
They're the source of magic. We didn't create anything.
Yeah, so hopefully if we kill the last witch, that should do it.
All right.
I thought, like, kill the witch and it'll switch.
I thought the witch was good. That was good. Leader was the person that caused the blizzard, not the witch.
Nah, it's the witches. No more dying. All right. All right. Head to the back. Okay. You can't die. I can't save you.
All right, I'm in the back.
Well, yeah, I mean, we don't really have enough time to take a rest at all or anything.
No, let's go. Let's charge in.
We're not going to even take a knee real quick.
You take a knee?
Does anyone need health?
No, I just need like a quick little nappy poo and I'll be good.
No, hell no. Let's go.
Like a little tiny.
Kinda.
Like
you want to kill,
Yeti.
Right?
Like a piece of Yeti, and
I guess I kind of have to now.
Why? Because you're the hero?
Yeah.
Well, at least they think I am.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I only took 4 points of damage that whole time.
Yeah, the only one that was really injured was him, and Bobby's magic is all but cured him of just a few scratches.
Yeah, so I'm golden.
Excellent.
So we take like quick little healing packets and make us back better.
Feeling a pizza. Well,
some Theraflu.
Feeling a pizza. Yeah.
There is no quick action. You either take a short rest, which is an hour, or...
Yeah, an hour is going to be fine. You won't know we're coming.
No, we attack now.
All right,
let's go. Attack while the iron's hot.
Sure, I'll lead. If I'm going to lead, I'm going to turn into a fire elemental.
Do something like that. That'd be great.
Go. I will. Good.
All right. So the group starts descending. You see, this passage is very interesting. It seems very
Frostbrand bang
round, almost like you're going down the throat of something.
Ooh. Oh no, are we in a dragon?
Oh man.
You're giving it heartburn.
Yeah.
I'm not fire elemental yet. Well, maybe I should. Yeah, actually, preemptively, I'm going to turn into a fire elemental.
Remember, that uses both of your charges of transform.
Wait, we're walking into a throat-like tunnel?
Yeah, it's like a sphere tunnel.
It's a circle. There's a little dangly thing, the uvula.
No, but it looks like carved stone. It doesn't look like the Millennium Falcon's going inside of a worm in an asteroid.
I don't get that reference. Anyway.
Not at all.
Nope.
You are mean today.
Compared to any other day.
Yeah.
Somebody did not want to play with you on the seesaw today.
Jeez.
Yeah, let's move on through. Do you mind leaning in the front? You seem like a hearty young chap.
Yeah, you're the hero. You gotta go in the front.
Yeah, we now made you king of your people.
Who has the second most life here?
That would be
you. How much do you have?
You.
Before I got hit, I had 124. Now I have 120.
Yeah. All right, so you're second. I'll go third. You guys.
I'm next, and then him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Brian's limping up the
rear.
No,
actually, he's next on me.
You're behind shadows.
All right. As you guys are heading down the tunnel, you can see like a blue light emanating from the end of this tunnel. After you'd probably guess. You can go stealth, that's fine. There's nowhere really to hide behind other than your companions.
Well, I'm at the end, so there you go.
Yeah. And so you're at at the back of the party?
Yeah. Hiding in the shadows.
Okay, as the party is walking, and who's in front?
No,
he is. He's the
Kiner,
hero.
You're walking, Kiner. You take a step, and you hear...
I broke the...
broke the chair.
This chair really
goes you're not
back?
Supposed to lean back like this in these chairs.
Yeah,
I guess.
You heard exactly that sound. And you notice the step you place, you notice there's a little like dish like this that sunk down about 3 inches into the tunnel.
This is why we should cut it.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, you are one.
You're in the back, and you're in perfect sight to see about 60 feet behind you. A hole opens and you hear a rolling and you see this
Indiana Jones.
Is this a boulder?
Comes down and starts rolling down the tunnel.
No!
What?
We need to run.
One of us does.
All right, John, I just push you guys all the way, and I just keep running.
He's just gonna melt into stone. It's gonna roll through him.
All right. If we hold on to you, can't you take us with you?
It landed about 100 feet behind you. It is rolling at 60 feet around.
We all run.
You guys can move at 60 feet around only if you dash to stay in front of it.
Let's dash. Boulder dash.
Boulder dash.
I'm assuming there's like no gaps on either side to like.
It's like literally like about half an inch clearance on each side of the tunnel as
Wait
it's
a
rolling.
Minute.
You're gonna open a dimension door, Brian?
Finally! No. What if I suck up the boulder? Would my web be strong enough to hold it in place?
No.
Why not?
You would say that the stone is guessing about 4 tons.
And what is my web?
Nothing. No. Not four tons. Not 4 tons.
Can't we destroy this boulder?
Run.
Where are we gonna run
Just
to?
Just run.
All the way to the end.
What if we... All right, let's run to the
I'm
end.
I'm using cunning action.
Just have your dimension door.
I want to use intimidating presence on the boulder.
Yeah, but what about dimension door? What if I see a dimension door up behind us as we run? The boulder going to dimension door. I don't give a shit where it goes.
That might work.
Can we do that?
It's gonna crack.
John's like, it's gonna look crushed.
Dimension door. What is this?
I'll look it up.
No, we just got to put the boulder through the dimension. Do I need to roll?
It opens up. No, it drops the boulder through. It depends on the range.
He goes through it.
Oh, but I don't want to go through it. I just put it and we run.
No, you have to go through it.
It's not an acne freaking thing.
It's like an acne thing.
Why not?
Because you're not part of the
dimension door. You teleport yourself from your current location to any other spot within range. You arrive at exactly the spot desired.
Oh,
No. He can bring one willing creature.
The boulder's not a creature.
Who's the other slowest?
No.
Of your size,
you can teleport yourself. And one other person
who's
behind the
wait
behind the boulder.
If we all dash,
will he be able to go back and forth and get all of us before the thing actually runs over the last person?
That's ridiculous.
What if we go through and I just put my hand through it and pull everybody in?
That's a lot of magic.
What spell is what level is dimension door?
Fourth.
Yes, fourth.
So if you want, you could take
three.
Three?
Oh, you're right. It's four. I'm sorry. But
you can
I'll take him. I'll take him because he has.
Huttle's the slowest. Here's the problem. He's covered in armor.
You can. It has to be smaller than you.
Oh, yeah, that's not gonna work.
So that'll be you.
Your size or smaller.
Yeah, you guys are both medium.
So he
you're
can
all
go
medium.
With me. So you can go with me. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, I'm the only
I'm gonna
really
take
large
him.
One here.
You want to go
it's
behind the boulder?
I'm screwed no matter what. Yeah.
But all right. Well, here's my only concern. What if we go behind the boulder? They dash in front of it, and it. Basically shuts them off into whatever passage.
My original thing is, what if we can go, but I can't see it, is the end of the tunnel. Is that possible to go to the end?
If you're going somewhere you don't, haven't seen before,
well, I can't
you have a chance of showing up into
a wall. Or
something. Let's go behind the boulder.
Yeah, but that'll cut
we can
us
break
off.
It.
After a while.
Yeah, it takes a lot to sunder an object of that.
And all the energy you're going to be using is going to be pushing it towards us even faster.
No, because it'd be at the end of it, if it stops, he's saying.
Oh.
Yeah, my concern is like, me and Brian will be safe. It'll be fine. You guys
really
will dash
good.
In front of it and get into whatever room
timer.
You're trying to reach. But then the boulder's going to lock you in it and us out of it, which will split the party in half.
Do you still have to disintegrate, or did you use that already?
He
that
used
gone?
It.
Gone?
Oh, I can, yeah, I did use it, but it's just a... Older.
Oh, that's right. It's an inanimate object, so it would be an instant destroy.
But what's your choice?
He used the spell already, so...
Yeah, you don't have access to it anymore. So are you going to save you and Hutzel?
I say we dash for it.
Want that? Nope, we're going to boulder dash.
All right, I'm using Hutzel. I'm using my...
Were you about to dash. Say I'm using Hutzel as my
action.
Shield?
Yeah, I really feel like we're
cunning action.
It would have been interesting. Because what if the boulder went off a cliff and these guys all fell into this lava pit and we lived?
You basically, you could use 4 spell slots to save the entire party.
How would he do that?
No, you'd have to use more than that.
What?
To teleport one guy, yeah, then teleport back, then teleport
like
another
8.
Guy. Yeah, you don't have enough magic for that. Yeah.
That's not possible?
No.
It would earn you the MVP place, that's for sure, but no.
Wait a minute. All of a sudden, he becomes Nightcrawler, and he's like,
exactly.
hey, guys, hey.
But if I took Hutzel with me the first time, but then I'd have to go back
oh
that
my.
All right.
What part of no do you not understand?
We've already,
You can use higher level spells to cast a lower level spell, but you only have five spells that would be capable of doing Dimension Door.
Gotcha.
So you could blow all of those.
No.
And you wouldn't be able to save everyone. You'd only be able to save two people.
Yeah, all right, all right. We're boulder dashing it, so gotcha. It doesn't matter.
All right, as you're coming down, you see a light at the end of the tunnel, and you see that it opens up into a crevasse. And
nice word.
It just drops down, and there's an icy bridge that goes across into the continuing the tunnel on the other side.
Oh, God.
All right. Let me see.
At least I have athletics.
So who's going across the bridge first?
I guess I am, because I'm in front.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. All right.
See if I was...
This boulder, the boulder's gone, ball. Right?
Or is yeah, but you're not faster than them. You're just as fast as them.
So the boulder's still behind us, yes?
Yeah, but you can't double dash. You can dash
well,
for free and then do an action in addition. They can only run. So they're like full out running. You're running, and you could still do something if there was something you wanted to do.
Well, then why wouldn't we've come to the end of the tunnel, which opens up into this huge canyon.
The bridge does start collapsing. I could jump.
Because we're not going to stop talking about that. The other
yeah, they're just running.
They're still following us.
Yeah.
Oh, give me an acrobatics check.
Acro check. Jeez.
My concern is it's going to break the bridge before we all get over it.
That was my other thought.
That's a 20.
Maybe we should walk behind.
You see him. He runs. You see he's starting to lose a little traction on the bridge because the bridge has no stone. It's just ice. Mm. But he's able to keep enough sliding, and he slides across the bridge into the tunnel beyond.
I got my knee.
Next person.
Me.
I just slide across the bridge if I know
well,
it's ice,
wouldn't that be
though?
Me? I was the next in order.
Wouldn't I?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
All right, Rob. Acrobatics.
Grab a d20.
Yeah, I'm trying to think if there's anything I can do to, like, help
you don't
want
to hold yourself. You want to just keep going straight.
All right. This is a d20, yes?
Yes.
Yeah. Is it a dex
check?
It's
an acrobatics check.
Okay, so that's a +4 in proficiency. Oh, fuck.
What does that mean?
I got a 12.
Oh, that's not so bad.
All right. You see he runs onto the ice. You see him slip. You can hear the scraping of his gauntlet trying to grab the ice, and you see him go right off the side of the bridge.
Can I throw him a piece of rope?
Nope, not yet.
You hear splash, and he lands in freezing cold water.
Oh, God. And in armor.
Next one to the bridge.
Which would be
me. Sure. Yep. Here we go. Oh, that's nice. Perfect. 18 plus whatever. I'm sure I made it.
Yep. He as almost as gracefully as Kiner, Chester makes it across, sliding down. He's got a lower
like a ninja turtle.
He's got a lower mass of center of gravity, so he kind of just gets across.
Doing guns. All right, the
next
whole
person
way.
To go.
That's me. 17 plus whatever. What am I?
All right. Kazaa also slides across, lighting off little sparkle measure of sparklers out of his hands.
Little cantrips.
All right.
I'm the one doofus that fell off the pit.
It is to you, Miles.
Wile E. Coyote.
Was that? You going to jump over the stone?
I'm going to jump in after Hustle.
Hey, you should jump in after Hustle.
Ooh, wow.
No one else did.
Have rope, right?
Yeah, and I got a climber's kit, so I can get out.
You have to carry him.
No, I can. I'm not hurt. I just fell in the ice.
You fell in the ice. All
right. Well, you twist your knee, buddy? Do you have strawberry soda?
You need a band-aid.
Only if it has one job on it.
Remember when we were at that show? Was that at the show? Was
like, all right, so the three of you made it to the other end. The two of you, he lands next to you.
If I use cunning action, can I throw them the rope as I dive into the water?
I love punks.
Yes, you can do an action while dashing.
Oh, check you out.
This is cool.
Wow, dashing with dash, double dash.
15. Is that, what is that?
It's dex. It.
Plus 5, 20.
All right. So as you're throwing, you pull out your rope and you throw it to them. Is someone going to catch it?
Got it.
And he just grabs the rope and jumps off the bridge.
Brace
towards
myself.
Meld into stone.
I can't. It's not my turn yet.
I'll grab the rope behind him.
Yeah, of course.
We'll both be pulling it. I'll grab
your anchor.
Except when I do that, No, it won't. It doesn't come with me, buddy.
Why wouldn't it? It's attached to you.
I'll let that. That would be pretty cool.
Very cool.
See? Thank you. You're like, oh, angry at this something. Right into the wall.
See? Yeah? See?
Like a wonder twin. Like turning into a wonder twin now.
Action hero.
You just turn into a bucket of water.
This is beautiful.
All right. So now.
Didn't expect that one, did you?
That happened? Wait, are you going to meld in the sun?
Slid across the bridge. What is flailing away in the water.
That, oh, you're fine. We'll be right back.
That is a level 3.
All right. So he melds in. The rope is now anchored into the wall. The other two of you are standing there. He lands next to you with the rope.
I tie it around Hutzel.
All right, you tie it around Hutzel.
Then send him up.
You throw him over your shoulder.
At this point, you see the ball. You have one round to get up before the ball crosses the bridge.
Oh, crap. Wait, where the hell are I? I'm on the other side just waiting for the rock to come towards me. Can I do something to, like, knock the rock?
You can keep running down the tunnel if you want.
Yeah, but if...
But you have, technically,
he's
make an intelligence check.
You two are alone.
Make an intelligence check. Grab your D20 and make an intelligence check.
You can figure that out in your head.
Keep
running.
16 plus your intelligence modifier.
5.
So 19. That's 21.
Yeah. 16 you realize plus 5, that as 21. You guys were sliding over, the ice was cracking. There is a 4-ton stone ball
coming
to go across that bridge.
I want to stop it and throw it into the water.
No.
We're in the water, you idiot.
It's going to go into the water.
Oh, then who cares?
Because we're in the water and it's going to
You'll be fine.
I got one turn to get up the bridge, dude.
Got one chance to get.
So the only way you're going to get out
in time
is to make a dash action while climbing.
Oh my god.
So I want a climbing check with disadvantage, both of you.
Roll, yes.
Now, strength modifier, yes.
You roll two times, you take the lower roll.
We gotta get them out.
Like breaking the boulder into bits?
14.
I wanna break.
So I had a 19 and a 9.
So 9. 14 and 9. Plus what?
Plus 5, which is my strength modifier.
Oh, so 19 and a 24.
So 9, 10.
Well, you take the weaker one.
Yeah, which is 9 plus 5.
So you're 14. So you have 19.
I got a 14.
I have a 19 if I'm
right. 14.
So
14?
What do you
guys? All right, 19. Doesn't look like Hustle's going to make it out in time.
Can I Thunder Wave the boulder to throw it back up the tunnel?
Do you think it's going to be powerful enough? There's something else you could do, maybe to buy him a turn, maybe.
Buy him a turn?
Can I grab the rope and just start, like, hauling?
Wait a minute, do you know haste?
I met the man.
There's one thing you like to do. It may not stop the boulder, but it may slow the boulder.
Oh, the missile?
Web?
What the fuck is
magic
missile?
Web. Magic missile?
Web, sir.
Oh, the web? You told me the web wouldn't do anything.
It wouldn't stop the ball. Like, Hutzel's like, Lord Albert Shaw is coming up the road.
All right, I'll do the
he's
hold
like,
on, hold on,
he's
hold
like
on.
10 hold feet on. From the top.
Hold on, if he casts haste on me, does that remove my disadvantage? Because if it did, that would make my roll a 19 plus 5.
That makes more sense than doing a web. Because
but the boulder's still coming.
The problem is you've already
passed that turn.
Yeah, you've already made your check.
All right.
You can't retroactively. Yeah.
You can't go back and be like, oh, you were bad, so here's another.
I'm totally fine with doing the web, but you told me that.
Well, that was before when we were running away from it, but now you're trying to slow it down.
All right.
Because it's going to fall into the river once we get out of
it. You web it.
That's what I wanted to do.
And it holds it just for about 8 seconds. Well, he gets to the top, the lid of the cavern, and then it breaks through the webbing, hits the ice. You hear the ice crack after about 10 feet. It just goes right down into the water.
Yeah, we got you out.
Dude, imagine if I didn't dive in after you.
Oh, yeah, I would have died. let's face it, I suck at saving throws.
You wouldn't have died. The boulder only does 10d10 points of damage.
Okay, yeah, so but I just would have drowned. And then someone would have had
to. Because we'd have to fish you out.
Who doesn't help them out.
Yeah, who's going to fish your huge ass out of the water full of metal?
All right, you are now no longer being chased by a giant boulder.
Hooray. Gigantic crane getting a new prize.
It's actually a gigantic dump.
It's a giant Husa stadium.
There's a gold stone. Because we're in a drag.
Yeah, we're in a drag. There's this gold. There's a big turd.
Yep. Wow.
So the group of you go down this tunnel.
It brings you through a chambers. This chamber looks like it's been recently used.
Oh, okay.
Can I ask a dumb question?
Very lavish furniture and like silks and all kinds of different things. You see on one wall there's a library of shelves full of different books.
Ooh, Brian upgrade.
And you see in the corner there's one of those folding walls like that you put up while you change. And you see a wardrobe of different, very revealing and alluring women's clothing.
I already like this.
A Chinese curtain? That's what they're called.
And there's you see another passage that heads out the back of this room as well.
Men, we are going to be fighting a woman who is going to try to use her sexual
prowess
to sway all of you. I need all of you to be firm and constitute resolve.
I'm firm, all right.
I'm firm. Darn it.
This
will never work. Keep it in. Miles.
I'll keep it in, all right.
If you must, think about maybe his sister that you might have boned.
Well, that's not a good thing to think about.
Oh, that's a terrible idea.
Terrible idea.
All right, so what is the group going to do?
We're all going to jerk each other off to get it out.
We do not have the time for that.
Circle jerk.
We're going to think about our grandmothers or something.
Everybody get their grandmas in their head.
So they don't get, like, you know, charmed.
What? That's so random.
All right.
We're going to charm our grandmas?
You go past through the chamber where you assume where the witches live.
Before we leave the chamber, is there anything we notice that's...
I said there's all kinds of things in
sexy
here.
Sexy negligence.
Well, then let's do a spot books. Check. Let's do a search. Let's do a search.
I search her panties.
I want to do a history.
The history of women's clothes.
We said there's books.
This clothing was worn a decade ago. This is so out of fashion.
You said there was books.
Yeah, but what are you history checking the book for?
What are you checking books for?
Well,
you're looking at titles? I've heard of this title. This book was written 40 ago.
Looking for that precious first edition.
All right, arcane of like...
Arcane of the books? You want to read the books?
Yes.
He wants to see if any of them are magic books.
Yeah, any magic books.
Are you a speed reader?
Spell books.
Magic books.
This one's written by Harry Anderson.
That's what I meant to say.
The arcane won't reveal if there's any magic books, but you could cast Detect Magic if you have it.
Did you take it?
Detect magic.
Can I just ask why there's still a blizzard noise when we're inside a cave?
Because it's windy in the cave.
There's always one.
You should have some magic.
Is there any? Is there a fireplace in this little room?
True seeing.
No, that's right. Because it was a woman's
freezing
chamber.
Water can
warm up.
Can go dry themselves.
I'm not seeing it on that.
Here, so it's a level one spell.
Yeah, detect magic.
Yep. You can cast it, right?
Yeah.
All right, you can cast that. You don't need the fucking roll.
No,
I thought I would roll.
Everything.
I don't know.
He just rolls the roll.
I like rolling.
You do not detect any magical life of books.
All right.
Surprise, surprise.
You don't detect anything of magic in here.
All right.
I mean, she's not here.
No, she's obviously not in this room.
She's naked somewhere else.
All right. I want to look through the clothes.
There's a lot of clothes. None of it's
clothes.
None of it's really useful for this weather. It's all super revealing and not warm.
Guys,
all right.
Montage, will we all try on the women's clothes?
No.
Huh?
I mean, I don't mind actually getting like a new hat.
Yeah. If we can do like the music montage. In the bag.
We just take out like, is there a brassiere I can attach to my head?
Yeah, we want the bras on the head, like
we,
Weird
yeah,
Science.
Can we?
Yeah.
If you really want to.
Yes.
Can Weird Science play in the background?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm good
fakely,
with that.
I fakely jab the fake thing into my head.
Okay, so there's literally nothing of any use in this room whatsoever.
There are a lot of books, but it's going to take you time to sift through the books.
Can I check the bed?
Oh, you know you want it.
Interesting smells.
Oh my god! I knew you were gonna go there!
Bazinga.
I like to roll.
Roll.
Wait, turn into a wolf.
Oh, 14 plus my propelling perception.
Okay, I hate to do the corny throwback, but so maybe 19. We should have the thief check the bookcase for a secret door.
Fair enough.
Do that.
There may be some books on small business ownership.
Do I smell jasmine? Small do I smell?
You say jasmine?
There's definitely scented.
That's nice. Mm.
There's more than women that have slept in this bed.
Oh. I can smell that too, huh?
Yeah.
Jizz.
Does it look clean?
Cleanish that you would expect from a barbarian tribe far from civilization.
Okay. That's impressive, considering it's a barbarian tribe. Guys,
sweet and salty.
This Bobby, bed, right?
That bed smells like
sweet and salty.
It smells like saltwater taffy.
Savory. Guys, it smells used.
So like saltwater taffy?
Yeah, roll to see if there's a secret compartment behind the bookcase or something.
We got 13. What is it? Intelligence plus.
Should be like that should be something you're proficient in, I'm guessing, because you're basically looking for like a mechanism or something. So what's your proficiency bonus?
I don't know.
Would you roll?
A 13.
Proficiency bonus. All
right, you.
plus 4, 17.
You look for a while.
No passageways here.
There are no passageways behind the bookshelf.
So nothing of any interest.
There's just the one
pathway
that goes out.
Can you
walk
down this hallway finally, you knuckleheads?
All right.
The one pathway that goes out.
You head down about maybe 50 feet. It comes to like a cylinder like passage that goes down, and the hallway kind of goes out into the middle of it on a platform, and in the platform there is a spiral staircase going down.
Please tell me the staircase is not made of ice.
No, it's stone.
Oh, thank God.
Well, I guess we go down.
That would have been like another like Scooby-Doo Mysteries intro right there.
Does anyone have like any kind of like something that casts light?
Yeah.
We all have torches.
There's still that pale blue light emanating from.
We could throw a torch farther down the hall.
Okay, so it's lit then.
Yeah, there's dim light.
But do we want
it seems to like bounce and vibrate over the gleam of ice on all the walls.
The stairs?
Yeah.
You can see down to the bottom of the stairs?
No, it's over 100 feet down.
That's what I'm saying. You can toss something down and see how far down it is.
Yeah, you could do that.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Sure.
Let's throw
Brian.
Yeah, I'll go down there.
You throw Brian over the side of the stairs.
Guys, it's really far down.
Actually, we throw Hutzel down because he's covered in mail or whatever it is.
Yeah, because, you know, that'll make me bounce when I hit the bottom.
Yeah, you just throw down your torch.
Yeah,
You think it's about 150 feet down.
Okay.
Nothing makes any kind of nothing movement wise happens.
We don't hear ouch.
You don't hear it hit the ground. But you see as it gets lower, the light of your torch kind of gets overwhelmed by this blue light coming from the bottom of the staircase.
Hmm.
It's because it's kind of it's this light is the same light you've been seeing since you entered this passage.
Let's go to the TD.
Be more little ice imps waiting for us.
So marching order, same as before.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Second verse, same as the first,
but just a little bit worse.
Can I use my danger sense?
Oh wait a minute. Maybe we should change our order. So that the one person that can detect traps in our group can actually find them.
This is page 46.
Yeah.
Well, give me 1 second.
That would be.
Mark, you got detect traps.
Life of danger? No.
Do you have that?
Yes.
Rage danger.
Should be
at second level, you gain an uncanny sense of when things are nearby aren't as they should be. You have an advantage on dexterity saving throws against effects that you can see, such as traps and spells. To gain this benefit, you can't be blinded, deafened, or incapacitated.
All right, that does help you. As you're coming down, and you step on a step, and you hear a clicking noise.
Balls.
Oh, God, come on, I knew it!
However, you get an advantage on this saving throw. Stairs, as he steps on one of the stairs, and all of a sudden the stairs all decline down into a slide.
Come on.
It's the scene in the Simpsons
House
episode
with Hill.
We hit
everyone the make a dexterity save. He can make advantage, because he noticed it was happening before it started happening.
You're done for.
Man.
13.
I suck at saving throws.
15.
11.
Now, is this considered like athletics, acrobatics?
Dexterity.
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 All right, so
14. Whatever it is, plus 5.
16.
16.
16, 14, whatever. What'd you
11.
Get?
11.
What'd you get?
Fail. 8.
Okay. Can all right, so
evasion and
you're unable to stop something. Yourself from falling. So you basically are riding it down. So the three of you land on the bottom, standing. You're fine. You just rode down the stairs really fast. You guys lost your footing and kind of just like slid at the bottom of the stairs. You guys kind of like just slid out.
Oh, you two.
Me?
Yeah.
No, I got these two.
Oh, I got 18. Oh.
Like, so, like, as I'm sliding down these stairs, is my armor just like causing sparks guy in the to fly up all over the place?
Yes.
In a red vine?
Yes, thing? It is.
Looking like Chevy Chase.
A giant metal luge.
So you each take 7 points of damage.
What's seven. Hmm? Seven damage.
Yeah, put that on your red vine. Looks like you just robbed a candy store.
And so at the bottom, there's in the center of the room, there is like an octagon-shaped pedestal.
Oh, God. More traps.
There's 5 pathways that go out of it. In between, there's water, which is currently frozen completely solid. So you guys came down. You guys are all standing on one of the 5 passageways that go into the main pedestal. You two came down and just slid off into the ice.
Oh, no.
Standing in the pedestal, you see this, like, like prism of mirrors. And standing beneath it is the last witch.
The last witch or glass witch?
The last witch.
Okay, I thought you said glass witch. I'm like, she's made of glass now?
The fence of the upper. Yeah, sure, I'll take it. Do it. Oh, I got two.
Okay, so she is standing beneath a giant ice thingy. I mean, giant.
And everyone rolled me initiative.
How long did you set it for?
Because she heard you guys coming.
Yeah, yeah, no duh.
It's 11:30. How long did you set the DVD for?
Mark, how long did you set the DVD for?
Then just keep recording because it's a.
Oh, you. Okay.
Oh, okay.
I got a 19.
What is it now?
I got an
initiative.
Initiative.
That's correct. What plus what?
Your initiative.
Oh, okay. I have a 21.
Wait. Oh, still. Because
I'm what you got.
8.
Jester?
You were 12.
Kiner?
4.
Nice.
Really? You got a 4?
I got a 4.
You can make fun of me.
It's just an initiative.
I know. Out real fast.
Trying to get going. The bad rolls out of the way.
The witches
now.
In the middle?
Yep.
We slid just randomly on one of these little ice paths and where the our heroes.
Yeah.
Right there?
Gotcha. Yeah, that's good.
Okay, gotcha.
He doesn't care. Oh, that's
sure.
I like the painted scene.
That's good.
Like,
yeah.
I know. We're just like, he's like, yeah, sure.
This, like, this is sort of helping out maybe some inspiration points.
Oh, boy.
Derp, 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 derp.
Walk, 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 walk.
Can I see your drawing? Weird? I want to see.
You're drawing boobs.
Oh, sweet.
Chicka boobs?
Chicka boob boob.
Chicka bow bow. All
right.
Let's see here. Kazai, you're over there. We're slid. Chester, that's me. We got LAS, that's Lord Albert Shaw. Mm-hmm. I got M. Mai, which is Miles, and there's Killian.
And the witch is standing right in the middle. All I need to know now is where is the leering dwarf hanging out? I'm guessing near the witch, yes?
No, he's actually, they're right underneath in the actual frozen ice.
Okay,
there's
so
a little frozen
up.
Little guy going,
okay, it's like Disney World. Mickey Mouse heads everywhere. The leering dwarf is everywhere.
Since he took a potty break, I will also too before we get into the thick of it.
Yeah, you're right. I got to take
Alan a pee. Thick of it?
In the thick of
Alan
it.
Alan thick of it?
I'm going to go pee.
You ever
no,
see
we're not going to take it that quick. We're going to take a quick break.
Well, I'm saying you want to get Mickey.